It's Jason Bear Bradley getting ready for the big scrimmage tonight here at Grimson. Coach, first of all, what kind of preseason has been for you? How's the practice gone?
You know, I think preseason's been really well over the summer. We've had a lot of guys committed, and, you know, we got 16 seniors, so they've really stepped up and embraced the grind. And, you know, one of the best things I told our guys, you know, we've been going in the afternoons at 6 o'clock, and so we've missed a lot of thunderstorms and weather. So, you know, as far as heat acclimated, I feel like we're already heat acclimated because we're used to going in this heat and this time of day. So I definitely think that's going to be an advantage for us going in the weeks ahead, just because, especially with warmer weather, we've gotten used to it.
Maybe catch a little bit of break today. It's hot today, but not quite as humid as it's been.
Yeah, absolutely. That's what the kids talked about. You know, it's amazing that, you know, when you've got them in pretty good shape and where they're at, and, you know, a lot of them was talking about, like, this feels like a fall night, Coach, and they was, you know, excited because it hasn't been as humid or as hot and to them. And so I think for that, that just goes to speak to the coach and staff, Coach Jones, and over our strength and conditioning part of it, and just, you know, getting the guys prepared, and, you know, they're just ready to play tonight.
Talk about the competition you'll be seeing today.
You know, we're going to have face a good, you know, North Forsyth and Ashboro team. They're going to come out, and so, you know, they're both always very big and athletic and physical, but I think that's a good test for us because, you know, next week we're going to face big and athletic as well, and so that's with Southeast. So, you know, we've been tested so far. You know, we went against Central Davidson and Thomasville, so we've seen some action, so I definitely, you know, like where we're at so far.
What did you like from what you saw when you saw Central Davidson and Thomasville games? What did you see in those games or your scrimmages there that you liked about your team?
You know, we just played hard. The tenacity, the flying around. Definitely like the – I love where our shape is right now. I love where we're at. I feel like we're in good shape far as our physical abilities. You know, we had some good things. We had good things from where we got, you know, dual quarterback enrollments right now. We got Jamais Ferrer, who returned from last year, and he can see wide receiver action some this year because we've had a sophomore step up, Noah Bradley. So both of them are competing for the starting position. And, you know, and both of them have keys. And so that's the thing that we looked at is, you know, I told the coaches the other day, it's not necessarily we're in a predicament because they both do some things very well. And what one can't do, the other does very well. And so they complement each other. And so, you know, we may go into, you know, week one with running a dual quarterback system.
And Noah gave us some time in relief last year, too. He saw some time late in some games, had some experience. He got that in last year.
Yeah, he did. And I think the biggest thing for him, this, you know, going into the summer, you know, was that, you know, he just, you know, had to take some step up, especially when Jamais, you know, Jamais is an, you know, great athlete, and he's a great basketball player. And so there was times, you know, Jamais had to go for basketball, and so, you know, Noah had to step up and be the guy during 7-on-7. So it was fun to watch him grow up, but it's fun to watch both of them in the relationship because they help each other. You know, Noah will help him with his reach, but Jamais will also give him advice all the time, too. And so it's good to have a veteran and see them, too, you know, get along. And so it's, you know, it's a beautiful relationship.
It's going to be a good thing, too, I think, for Jamais to see the ball from a different situation as a receiver instead of throwing. He'll be catching it. Might make him a better quarterback because he sees what those receivers are doing and knows what he needs to do to get them the ball.
Absolutely. The one thing that they picked up on was just talking about their reads. And, you know, they're having both of them and playing receiver here and there and some. And like Jamais, you know, they've learned, you know, with the deep ball, like sometimes you've got to let it go. You know, you got to wait when they're, especially when we got some speed. We got some speed out there with Gerard Copper and Ja'Cari Mann and Connor Field. So we, you know, there's times that we tell them, like, you know, you just got to put the ball up in the air and let the guys go get it. And so, you know, it's good for both of them to see, especially with Jamais, if he, you know, he's played DB some for us on the scout team just to give us a different look. And so, you know, with his athleticism, you've got to put the ball on the money, but you also learn you've got to release it a lot quicker than what you're normally used to.
And those basketball skills should come into play there, too, being able to get that ball as a basketball player going up, getting the jump. He can get the jump on the football. And also may help him down the road being able to play a different position. Who knows? That might open up more doors in college.
Absolutely. And like I said, Jamais is just a talented athlete. So, you know, we're excited to see where that's going to take him. But we're just excited to see over our, you know, our game plan. Like I said, we got 16 seniors from, like, Rydell Herbin to K.J. Lynch. And, you know, offensive line-wise, we've got, you know, Jason Creech, Malachi Bradley, Kirsten Pickett, and like I said, our mission Connor and them. But then, you know, so we got some guys that are coming back that's going to help us on both sides of the ball. That we're just excited to see where they're going to land.
And you can't get any tougher, in my opinion, than Rydell Herbin. That's toughness when you say that name. game, you think of toughness. He's been hanging in there for the past few years, and he enjoys, he kind of embraces the toughness of this game.
Yeah, Rydell was, you know, the kids will tell you, like, I talk about Rydell all the time. Rydell's probably one of my top favorite guys I've ever coached just because he's a guy that just shows up, doesn't talk a whole lot, not going to, you know, he's not a hoo-ha guy and hoo-rah guy, and he's not always going to come out with the fancy, you know, gloves or, you know, wristbands or anything cuteness. He's just going to show up and he's going to play football, and he's going to give you everything he's got. And so those kind of players like that get you really excited when you watch him because he just he's just a great person. Just a great person and a great athlete.
I know you like your, like you said, you like your big bears up front to those linemen. You always love to push those guys hard, make sure they're getting the door open before you get those holes open.
Absolutely. You know, we got a smaller line than what we've had, you know, in the past. You know, our guys don't weigh a lot, but, you know, I told them, like, we're going to have to play a quicker style game. And so, you know, that's one thing about our linemen. Our linemen, you know, can run sometimes. You know, people are like, well, they're small. But then I also look and think, they run about the average speed of a linebacker. So, you know, that can be good and bad. You know, you get underneath them and stay low, but then also when you get momentum and stuff, and when we, you know, we run our zone or our tall sweeps or those things, it's good to see those kids get out there and move.
It all boils down to just a few things. What are some of those things that are important for Southern Guilford to have a very good season this year?
I think the biggest thing for us is like I always tell them, like from last year, and, you know, it was a thing from last year where I came in the last playoff game and had some that health issue scare, and it's like I tell them, like, what is your legacy? Make every day count. And so I think for these seniors and these guys, it's about doing those little things every single day, and not just about football, but it's about life. It's about, you know, getting up and just choosing to do the right thing every single day. And I tell them all the time, like, you know, X's and O's, points on the board, all that will come. But right now what we're most interested in is just we're going to do the right things all the time. And I think for us, when we do the right things, good things will happen.
And I think you and I both have agreed, and your little daughter agrees, the more you watch that movie Facing the Giants, the better off you're going to be, the better off you'll get.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Coach, thank you for your time, and a good afternoon to you.
Thank you. You have a good one as well.